Well, it's been like a month and Joe and ReviewBot still aren't back, so shit. Will they be back in time for the 2018 Summer Games? Who the fuck cares? There's a new Winnie the Pooh movie out, but this time it's completely live action. Disney wants you to forget about a certain live action Pooh movie called Too Smart for Strangers, which is part of the show Pooh's Corner that was released in 1985 and, well, it's weird.
And here we go.
Is this Winnie the Pooh or Star Wars? What's up with the space background?
Too smart for strangers. That's me, Winnie the Pooh.
So yeah, Pooh is kind of terrifying. This is most likely because he was played by some weird adult in a really creepy costume. So Pooh is singing a song about strangers, so I guess the movie will be about how to stay safe, right? They'll probably not go too far into detail about strangers, as this is clearly for kids.
Too smart for strangers, that's me, Winnie the Pooh.
Pooh, are you claiming that you need to be too smart for strangers, as in that you are too smart for strangers, or that are you implying that you are a stranger? I'm getting mixed messages here.
My name is Winnie the Pooh, as you probably already know. What is a stranger, you ask? Well, let's see. Think.
Why the hell would you need to think about what a stranger is? You just said we need to be too smart for them. How the hell could you be too smart for something that you don't even know what it is?
A stranger is, well, it's not an easy thing to explain.
It's just someone you don't know. I just explained it for you, Pooh. Disney, can I get this bear's paycheck? Piglet is magically even more terrifying than Pooh. Jesus Christ, I'm not sleeping tonight. I just got over my nightmares from Shed 17, you bastards.
Hello, Pooh.
Piglet. Oh, I'm so glad to see you. I was just trying to tell our home friends at home what a stranger is. And now I want to touch your private parts. A stranger is something a piglet is not.
You're making this very, very complicated, Pooh. Come on, just get to the point.
Pooh, I think you mean that a stranger is someone you don't know. And since you know me, I'm not a stranger.
Yes. That's just what I said.
Fuck you, Pooh. You had no idea. You remind me of Brian from Family Guy.
You ever heard of the multiverse theory, Brian?
Well, of course I have, but I'm wondering if you have.
Oh my god, so transparent. Well, the theory state...
Wait. Come on now, we are better than this. We do not need to reference Family Guy to make a joke now. Come on.
Right, and don't forget, there are good strangers and bad strangers. And some strangers, the bad ones, want to hurt kids.
You know, Pooh, that's a nice way of putting it. Hurting kids is vague enough to not scare children, but it also explains that there are people like that in the world. Good job. Wait a minute. Would I be considered one of those bad strangers? Parents watching this, would you let me near your kids? But post a comment down below if you'd let me near your kids.
And bears, and even piglets.
No! Well, how can you tell which are good and which are bad, Pooh?
Jesus Christ, Pooh, you're scarring this guy.
You can't. And so that's why it's important to be not. I mean, just because he's friendly doesn't mean he's a friend. Be careful or you could get funked.
No! Pooh, just talking about strangers is scary to someone as small as I am.
Fun you, sissy. And now I want to fun your piglet ass. In fact, I have the right to fun you.
I couldn't resist.
But there are ways to help yourself.
Oh, I'm too small to help myself, aren't I?
Yes, that's right. In fact, you have no right to help yourself.
Pooh is a proud American. I salute you.
Say, Pooh, I'd feel safer inside your house.
I would not feel even close to being safe in that Pooh's house.
Oh, okay, Piglet. There's a fresh pot of honey inside, and this one is empty.
Sure hope there aren't any roofies in that honey.
Now, what was it I came in here for?
What?
I think I've forgotten. Oh, now I remember. Honey. Would you care to join me, Piglet?
No, no, thank you, Pooh. You know, I feel better knowing I can help myself, and that our friends out there can help themselves, too.
That mouth movement is spot on. You'd never know this was fake.
But how do we do it?
Well, I may forget a lot of things, but I never forget three things we must all know to help ourselves.
You mean three things to remember when I meet a stranger?
That's right, Piglet. Number one, say no to Mommy or Daddy. Number two, run away. Number three, tell your parents or a Nazi.
Hold on, Darkness,
you trust.
I should be able to remember those. Could we go over them together, Pooh?
Oh, of course, Piglet.
Jesus Christ, you just said that you could remember them.
If someone greets you on the...
And another song. No wonder this is 40 minutes long.
And offers you a ride or treat, say no, run away and tell.
Still, not better than Nothing Can Stop Us Now from the 1991 animated adaptation of The Little Engine That Could.
Take it away, Digger!
I couldn't resist.
Howdy roo, kid!
Unrelated, have you ever noticed how badass Pooh is? I mean, he mortally wounds himself regularly and he just takes it like a champ. He just shoves those internal organs back in there and sews his own flesh together. Even John Wick couldn't do that.
Hi, little Palaroo.
Hi, big Palarino.
That is not Roo. Okay, the other guys are scary, but at least they kind of look and sound like the original characters. That is not Roo.
My buddy and I go all kinds of places together, because it's more fun to go places with a friend, and it's good and safe, too. You know, Roo, we're supposed to tell the kids at home about fupping themselves when they're away from home.
But I'm so little.
Fup yourself, continue. First, you should avoid unsafe places.
What are they?
Places where there are no other people around. Look, there are alleys, construction sites. You know, those places where they're building a building or something.
Now wait just a second. Those places have nobody in them, then doesn't that mean that there are no strangers either?
Public restrooms?
Yeah, kid, just hold it in.
Karen knows she stayed too late, and she doesn't want to get in trouble. So, she decides to take a shortcut.
I'm sorry, but Karen is fucked. There's no way around it, she's fucked.
Well, what do you think of what Karen's done so far, little buddy Roo?
Well, I don't think Karen should have taken a shortcut all by herself. There weren't any other people around.
We clearly just saw another person there, so you're wrong. What if there are other people, and they're all communists? You think about that, Roo? You think about that? Where the hell was Reagan when you need him? Yeah, we need more movies about Reagan so we can teach kids how to stay safe. I personally would like to see a biopic about Ronald Reagan that features an epic scene where he mows down thousands of gays, drug dealers, and Russians alongside Michael Jackson and that kid from A Christmas Story. We can call it Reagan, a Star Wars story.
Righty-roo, buddy. It's better to stick to places where there's lots of people. But what should she do now that she's met a stranger?
I think she should run away fast. And tell an adult.
Tell an adult what? Literally all this guy did was exist.
Woohoo! Good thinking, Roo. Let's go back and see what Karen does.
Hey, kid, come here.
No!
Yeah, she yelled no to that child molester. That sure showed him. This clearly is the face of a man that has gotten schooled. Here's a little tip for all you fellow, deplorable pedophiles out there. If you want to attract a kid, don't yell, "Hey kid, come here," in the most overly creepy way possible. It has been proven to not work very well.
Glad to hear it, little pal. But even when you're in a safe place, like the sidewalk in front of a school or your own neighborhood, places you go all the time, you still have to be careful.
The question must be asked, are there any strangers in the 100-acre wood? It seems pretty barren to me.
Boy, I'm going to stay away from lonely, unsafe places.
So literally the entirety of the 100-acre wood. Look at this fucking place. There's no one here.
Glad to hear it, little pal. But Even when you're in a thick...
Why the hell is Tigger just pushing Rue now? Are they headed for a cliff?
Well, well, aren't you pretty little girls? What are your names?
Jesus Christ, how many fucking pedophiles are in this city?
Woohoo! That the Tiggerific answer, Rue. Don't ever give your name or your address or any information to a stranger.
But they didn't seem very friendly, Tigger. Wouldn't it be all right to say hello and maybe shake hands?
No, 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 Peru!
That was an awfully overdramatic motion to make.
Don't ever worry about being polite to a stranger. That's very important. And always keep at least an arm's distance from a stranger. But don't put your dick out, because a bad stranger might grab it.
What if somebody does grab me?
Then your foot and scream and kick and bite. Fight with all your might.
Gee, I never thought Tigger had a violent bone in his body. This depresses me.
Always tell someone you trust. That could be a mom or dad.
Or an aunt or an uncle.
Righty-roo, Roo. Or a grandparent or a neighbor or teacher. Tell someone that you trust.
Oh boy, another song, but still not better than... Then you have some fucked parents. Parents. Forgot that Rue's dad's in jail.
Let's find out what some of you would do if you met a stranger.
I wouldn't tell my name to a stranger.
I'd run really fast in the opposite direction.
You'll know and run.
Run, run, run.
The real stranger is the guy that went around town and filmed random kids' reactions to what they do if they meet a stranger. Guys, they're trying to learn their tactics. They're evolving.
My, my, I certainly learned a lot from Tigger and Rue.
They sure are smart about taking care of themselves.
So who and Piglet were just watching this whole thing from their window? What did they do when Tigger started to roll Rue off? That was a pretty decent distance.
Hey, what was that? Somebody's around here. Maybe it's a stranger.
Sorry guys, but Tigger is fucked. There's no saving him. He's a dead man.
Well, that's not a stranger. That's Eeyore. Howdy, Rue, Eeyore.
Eeyore, he reminds me of myself. I just want to die. Why won't the pain stop?
Tell me, what do you do if you meet a stranger?
I can't tell you that, cause no one ever notices me.
What the fuck? That's so sad. Why would you put this in?
I don't know, Eeyore, but it sure sounded like my old pal Longears.
Hey. That's their word now. You have no business using it.
Good guess, Tigger.
So, Rabbit is a magician.
Hey, kid, come here a second. I seem to have lost my dog somewhere around here, and I was wondering if you might help me try to find him.
No, sorry, I can't do that.
I feel bad for this guy. I think he genuinely needed to find his dog. There are so many fucking pedophiles in this town, we need a goddamn cleansing on this shit.
If the stranger is heading this way, you run that way.
You know, unless he's on foot, you should probably specify this only works if he's in a car.
Oh, come on, I won't hurt you.
No.
Yeah, saying I won't hurt you doesn't make for a very convincing argument. God, these pedophiles in this town are amateurs.
That's the spirit, Eeyore. Don't be fooled by tricks. Don't fall for a phony story.
Why do they continuously sing songs about the stuff they literally just talked about for 10 minutes? It's wasting my damn time.
Don't waste my motherfucking time!
Says the quote from the nearly 3-hour-long movie.
Don't be fooled by tricks. It's better to be safe than sorry.
Rabbit is practicing witchcraft. You're gonna burn in hell, Longears.
Now that's a trick bad strangers sometimes play. What would you do?
Well, I wouldn't go if I didn't know her.
Right. If she's such a good friend of Holly's mom, why doesn't Holly know her?
So what do you say? Don't go! If I heard you correctly, you said don't go. Now, all of you kids out there, what would you have done?
I'd call my mom and ask her about it. Don't go with somebody you don't know.
I think it would be real dumb.
Why are we doing this again? Why is this movie so fucking boring? How the hell are there 20 minutes left? What else is there to talk about? So now we have Al talking about what happens if people try to break into your damn house.
Here's Johnny!
Yeah, you're fucked.
Pretty complicated. Private Anderson is getting a chance to fire a revolutionary war machine, but only under strict supervision.
Hello?
Hi. What's your name?
Ryan.
Is your mom there, Ryan?
The fucking telemarketers are pedophiles too?
Okay, thanks.
Goodbye.
You see, after Ryan hung up, he had a funny feeling. So he called his next-door neighbor, Mrs. Jones, and she said she'd come right over.
Plot twist. Mrs. Jones was actually the caller the whole time, and she made this as an elaborate scheme to waste more time. Fuck you, Mrs. Jones.
Don't waste my motherfucker!
Shield doors. Shut up, Morty, you brainwashed little turd that might not even be real because I'm brainwashed too.
You know, Rick, this isn't easy for us. You know, we all remember you as a friend.
Oh, really? Well, I remember you as a whiny little piece of shit, Morty.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I've got about 1,000 memories of your dumb little ass, and about 6 of them are pleasant. The rest is annoying garbage. So why don't you do us both a favor and pull the trigger? Do it! Do it, motherfucker! Pull the trigger!
No, Dad! It was you! You made me this way! You made me this way!
Would you open the door?
Who's there?
I'm Mrs. Anderson. Is your mother home?
She's busy. Please come back later.
Rebecca didn't know a Mrs. Anderson, so she didn't open the door. Let's see what she does next.
Hi, Aunt Peggy. A woman I don't know just came to the door.
I'm sorry it had to be this way, but you simply know far too much.
So we are at yet another song. I'm really starting to get tired of this, so let's just skip to the reason you're all here.
Get out of my house!
Nigger.
I couldn't resist.
Well, that was certainly interesting.
Yes, it was. But, oh, I hate to mention it, Pooh. I really do. But I think we should tell our friends that danger doesn't always come from strangers. It can be from someone you know.
Oh, Piglet, you're right. People you see every day might want to touch you.
Oh, shit. They're not going there, are they?
And sometimes that's dangerous.
Stop it!
What do you mean, Pooh?
Do not answer that!
Well, there are certain private places on your body that nobody is supposed to touch except you.
Except you.
Your bathing suit covers your private parts.
I do not want this creepy, weird, blinking poo demon to talk about my dick, all right?
Sometimes your parents might touch them if they're dressing you or masturbating you. Or the doctor has to touch them when he's examining you.
Dude, I think my dad's a doctor.
That's okay touching.
Oh, but is there touching that's not okay, poo?
Oh, yeah.
Don't say oh yes like that ever again, please.
And that's the kind of touching that gives you a funny feeling inside. It feels wrong because other people shouldn't touch your private parts.
But Pooh, what do I do if somebody tries to touch me that way?
Have you guys ever wanted to see Woody the fucking Pooh talk about genitalia and child molestation? Is that something that people were just demanding to have happen? I don't know what to say here. Woody the Pooh was explaining to Piglet of what to do when you're getting molested.
No. Here's the important part. Your private parts. Is to touch you anywhere in a not okay way, a way that feels wrong, tell them, oh yes.
No matter who they are, Pooh.
Absolutely, Piglet. It's not always a stranger. Even if it's somebody you know or somebody you've seen at home, at school, or in your neighborhood, you have to say, oh, yes. If someone gets too near to your private parts, say yes loud and clear.
No, Pooh, stop. I do not want you to sing about private parts. Please don't.
Here's how. Say yes, don't stop that. It's okay with me. Yes, don't do that. I have the right, you see. My body is my very own. That's how it's got to be. I've learned this is the time to say it's okay with me. No, stop that. It's really not okay. No, don't do that. Take your hands away. I know I'm not at all to blame. I've done nothing bad. And now I'm going right away to tell my mom and dad.
Oh! Oh my God.
Who the hell made this? What were they thinking?
Now, Piglet, that's really all there is to it.
Yes, Pooh, I think I could do it.
No, no, don't. Don't get Piglet in on this. I think we're good here.
I'd say no. Stop that. That is what I'd say. No, don't do that. It's really not okay.
What's really not okay is this song, so please stop.
And don't forget, you have the right to say no. Now, suppose somebody tries to touch you in a not okay way. What would you say?
No. No, don't touch me.
Don't touch me, dear, or I'll tell.
Don't touch me, motherfucker. Get out.
If you touch me again, I'll tell my dad.
Why the hell would you wait for him to tell your dad? Tell your dad now.
Bravo, bravo. That's the way to be too smart for strangers.
Those boys and girls really know how to help themselves.
Did anybody mention tricks?
Well, no, Rabbit. I mean, not yet. I mean, where are you? There you are.
Oh, for fuck's sake, there's more? Why can't this fucking thing be over already? What more do you want me to see? You just had one of the most innocent characters ever talk about people trying to grab children's dicks.
Well, while you're here, why don't you tell us about tricks?
Glad you asked, Pooh. Now this time, I'm talking about tricks that bad people use to get you not to tell when they do something wrong to you, like touching you in a not okay way.
Again with the touching. You know, none of you idiots even have private parts to begin with.
No, my.
But no matter what kind of trick someone tries with you, remember, always tell your parents or someone you trust when someone tries to touch your private parts. And keep telling till someone helps you. Now, what would you do if someone says he'll hurt you if you tell?
It's just a trick. I'd still tell my mom and dad.
I mean, you shouldn't just assume it's a trick. If this person is wanting to molest a child, I don't think it's too far of a stretch to assume that they are capable of other actions.
Good. And if someone says they'd hurt your parents if you told?
I wouldn't believe them. I'd tell.
Again, you should still tell. But you shouldn't teach kids that every threat they ever receive is an empty one.
Threats bad people make are not true. They're just tricks to get you not to tell. Always tell if someone does something you think is wrong, even if they say it's a secret. Keep telling and telling. Someone will believe you. It's not your fault. Tell. Just say, Mom, Dad, that person touched me and it felt wrong.
This is some of the darkest stuff I've seen a kids show character talk about. I don't even understand the point of this anyway. This type of thing is taught to kids by their parents or their teachers. Sometimes cops even tell kids this stuff. I don't know if it's entirely necessary to have Pooh characters talk about this. It just doesn't really seem right. Why the hell doesn't this show ever teach kids to call the police using 911? They briefly show the number earlier, but considering how much repetition is in this, it's weird how they very rarely mention the cops as being a viable option. They should really go into more detail about what types of people you can comfortably tell if you're ever in a situation like this.
Tell someone that you trust. Tell someone you really must. Make them believe you. Keep telling them till they do.
This is terrible advice. If your parents don't believe you, you should then try to bring this up with the police or the teachers or other members of your family. You shouldn't make kids feel trapped into trying to convince two people of something horrible that happened to them.
Now, let's see if Carrie knows how to help herself. Carrie is telling her mom that somebody touched her in a way that felt wrong.
I'm very glad you came to me, Carrie. You were right to tell me. I'll see to it that this never happens again.
Way to go, Carrie. That's how to help yourself.
This just feels kind of apathetic. I mean, the kid was just molested in the context of this show, and all you say is, way to go, good job. Yeah, this kid is also scarred and possibly affected for the rest of her life.
If somebody does touch you in a not okay way, or tries to, tell someone you trust, like your mom or dad.
This message just doesn't get across when you have a guy in a horrifying pig costume with a permanent smile and puppet mouth saying it. So we have one final song and it's over. Okay, no, we have another song. Okay, now it's over. Holy shit, this was bad.
Yes, don't stop that. It's okay with me. Yes, don't do that. I have the right, you see. My body is my very own. That's how it's got to be. I've learned this is the time to say it's okay with me.